慈济人播撒善的种子，在南非则是看到了生根萌芽。南非德本就有这么一家慈济长期的照顾户，生活贫困，还掏出了身上所剩的零钱捐给海地。早上正言上人开示说，贫困的人可以觉悟，还可以爱别人的精神，令人感动。
利用下乡访视的机会，南非德本志工向大家介绍慈济，并带着照顾户一起为发生大地震的海地祈福，也向照顾户募心募款送爱到海地。这群本土志工虽然生活并不宽裕，但他们都懂得付出的道理。
他唯有智慧了，是他们终身要追求的，这就是菩萨。所以呢，我们人呐，总是在迷以悟了，就是穷困人，他觉悟了以后呢，他能安贫乐道，或者是安贫所道了，在人生的轨道上，不只是自爱，还会去爱人呐、真的很令人感动啊。
德本志工还走向街头发送募心行动文宣，邀请民众一同祈福斋戒。目前在南非已经有4000多位祖鲁族志工发心投入大爱的行列，用行动关怀爱滋孤儿，用爱贴近苦难人的心，把握当下，努力付出，让生活更有目标。
最重要是他们的心，他们的心啊，是那样的心宽念存啊。我们人生啊，都是心不厌久哈、那真正的那一种心不久啦。很苦哦，因为呢，心不久呢，它都是多求啊。这种的多求呢，是增加罪哦，真的增加罪恶啊。世间呢，不也都是这样吗？
穷困人生却能知足常乐，见苦知福，关怀苦难众生。力量虽小，但爱心无限。南非菩萨的精神值得敬爱。大新闻，林国兴、林宏志，花莲报道。
南非的德本有超过4000位的当地祖鲁族志工加入慈济行列，其中呢有这么一位妇女恬贝尼，她是两个孩子的妈妈，和先生带领18位的新进志工一起照顾62位的艾滋孤儿。不过其实她这一路走来并不轻松，因为她呢本身感染有艾滋病，又遭逢车祸，让她一度对生命是几乎绝望。不过在偶然的机会当中，从广播听到了慈济志工的分享，让他决定口音到电台，生命从绝望转向希望。
悠扬的歌声搭载着温暖，随着祖鲁族志工要进照顾户家中，按摩每一寸僵硬的肌肉。他是恬贝尼，做志工对曾经的他是不可能的任务。
2006年呢，那个时候我还在三扣这边工作的时候，在当守卫，然后那个时候呢，就是发生了被几个男士呢，就是侵犯。当时呢，我正怀着我的第二个小孩，然后也经这个事件之后，也诊断出有的我得到了艾滋病。
因为遭受性侵害，被感染艾滋的恬贝尼还遭逢车祸，下半身一度瘫痪的他，还得承受亲友的冷漠、邻居的排挤。慈济人的出现，恬贝尼从绝望迎向希望，甚至带动社区志工自掏腰包为孤儿供食。或许走出历历在目的伤痛不容易，但恬贝尼愿意也做到了。大爱新闻，南非德本报道。
In Durban, South Africa, an estimated 4,000 plus Zulu volunteers are serving with Tzu Chi. In our next story, we introduce to you one of these volunteers, Thembeni Langa, who is working with other volunteers to look after HIV/AIDS orphans in her community. Thembeni's story is a sad one. In 2006, when she was pregnant with her second child, she was gang-raped and contracted HIV from the assault. Then later on in 2007, a road accident left her temporarily paralyzed from the waist down. Feeling that the stigma of AIDS had disgraced her in her community, Thembeni was about to lose faith in life when the local Tzu Chi radio show brought her a ray of hope. Happy melodies herald the arrival of volunteers who are bringing sunshine into this home. As she carefully massages the patient, Thembeni wonders at how she became a volunteer.
When Thembeni worked as a security guard and was pregnant with her second child, she was sexually assaulted by several men, which tainted her with HIV/AIDS.
As if that isn't tragic enough, a car accident left Thembeni semi-paralyzed for a period of time. Feeling no love or support from her relatives and neighbors, Thembeni finally found hope when Cidi volunteers came into her life. Now, Thembeni is also a happy volunteer. She has even started a soup kitchen for the orphans in her community, extending the love in her heart that is now growing ever stronger despite her painful past.